Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Kamila Ramadina Lutfi from B class. Today, I'm gonna read my press release that I wrote. Pertiwi Indonesia distributes 500 packages of food at Petamburan Police Dormitory. Pertiwi Indonesia once again held social service activities during the COVID-19 pandemic. This time, residents of the Brimob Dormitory of Petamburan Police received 500 packages of food that were distributed symbolically in Jakarta. Packages of food delivered, Chairman to Pertiwi Indonesia, Hiranti Siret, was intended for Waraka, Wuri, pensioners Reda Tama, and orphans from the police environment of the residents of the Brimob Dormitory of Petamburan Police. Miranti said, as a form of concern from Pertiwi Indonesia, it helps residents in the police dormitory in the framework of the second anniversary of Pertiwi Indonesia. We also distributed food to citizens in the Petamburan Police Dormitory, added Miranti, who was accompanied by the head of Indonesia's national team, DKI Jakarta, Lucy Krisantina, and the head of Pertiwi Indonesia Central Jakarta, Astrid Esther. In addition, according to Miranti, the National Police as the vanguard in providing a sense of security for the police family in dormitory environment. During the pandemic, Pertiwi Indonesia is very concerned in helping families by handing over 500 packages of food to 600 heads of family. Moreover, Petamburan is a red zone of COVID-19, said Miranti, who is also a member of Bayangkari. As is known, Pertiwi Indonesia has distributed 15,000 packages of food to various levels of society in Jabodetabek, as well as 22,000 help distribute banpres. In addition, in the framework of his second birthday, Pertiwi Indonesia also handed over 1,000 mobile phones to the community that are used for students studying online. The government updated information on the development of daily cases of COVID-19 on Saturday. Based on data shared by the Task Force on Handling COVID-19 on Saturday afternoon, there were 4,000 new cases of patients confirmed positive for COVID-19. The data is calculated from 12 o'clock on Friday until 12 o'clock on Saturday. Thus, accumulatively, there are 1 million positive cases of COVID-19 in Indonesia today. The number of additions was obtained from the results of the examination of 67,000 specimens in the last 24 hours. Based on the data, new cases of COVID-19 positive confirmation patients are spread across 34 provinces. The overall transmissions of COVID-19 to date occurs in 500 districts or cities located in 34 provinces. Then, the government also noted that there were an additional 4,000 patients who had been declared cured. Thus, the total number of patients cured from COVID-19 is 1 million people. In addition, there were an additional 100 patients who died after previously being declared positive for coronavirus. So the number of patients dying from COVID-19 today to 40,000 people. The following data spread new cases of COVID-19 in 34 provinces until 27 of March 2021. In DKI Jakarta, there's new cases is about 1,000. In West Java, there's new cases about 400 new cases. In East Jakarta, there's 200 new cases. And in South Kalimantan, there's 200 new cases. Fadil Jaidi seems serious in the business world. After Street Baba, this time the famous celebgram and YouTubers will release the business with PT Nikmat Group, launching Traffic Bun, accompanied by his family and friends. On Father's Day, he officially opened Traffic Bun outlet, which became his newest business on Thursday. According to him, Traffic Bun serves meat sandwich food or familiarly called hamburger. This became Father's second business, which he seriously persevered with. Traffic Bun outlet in Cracket Raya area is the first outlet of Nikmat Group company. Alhamdulillah, I have an idea to make this burger business continues to be assisted by Mr. Ronald Simanjuntak from Nikmat Group be this Traffic Bun, he said in Cracket, North Jakarta on Thursday. Ronald Simanjuntak, as a representative of Nikmat Group, also said that the discussion process with Father JD did not take long. In addition, there is also the meaning of the name Traffic Bun. Dove is a well-known beauty brand in Indonesia. It turned out to be the one of the special products of body care launches from Unilever. Unilever brand children who have had quarters in the Netherlands and England is quite popular in Indonesia, and the products are easy to get everywhere. With its slogan Dove Real Beauty, this brand creates an image that wants to make everyone think that beauty is many forms, especially in shampoo products from Dove Indonesia that have the name Rambutku Kataku. That's it. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.